All right, hello everybody. So we're gonna do some shortcuts, maybe the MR and four-wheel drive challenges and the Pagani challenge, this one. I don't know if this one will be easy. Since I don't have the Pagani race car, I don't know if that's going to be, like, really fast. Yeah, it is 5 in the morning, dude. Indeed. So let's try out that cup first. How you doing, dude? Check the requirements here. Just make sure I'm not doing something dumb and it'll disqualify my car. Okay. Hey Freddy. How you doing? I'm not gonna buy a bunch of things because I don't really want to waste money. Just in case I actually need the race car in order to beat it. Let's buy some cheap things. Don't really need that. Doing good, Freddy, thanks. Gonna be doing some... Ooh, that's 23,000. No thanks. Gonna be doing some professional league. So we're gonna do the Pagani Cup first. Yeah, well, yeah, that's true. I can use it for other events if it doesn't really work out here. But I think it should be good enough. Just depends on if the AI has the race car or not. Yeah, yesterday I did the 2 hours of Trial Mountain endurance event, and then I just got an... Oh, there's a bunch! They're all race cars! Ooh. Yeah, yesterday I did the 2 hours of Trial Mountain, and after 2 hours, I didn't even get a Formula Gran Turismo. You know, just some red line luck. Oh yeah, thanks Freddy. I work really hard on them. Damn, this car sounds wild. Okay, this might be doable. Okay, maybe not. The thing understeers a lot. Okay. I'm gonna do some more upgrades. Mess with the tune a little bit more. Yeah, I can't believe after 2 hours I only got an S2000 race car. Oh wow, that's 200 horsepower. Try it again. Yeah, I mean, there's only three cars allowed, and I thought some of them would be these two, but no, they're all race cars. Oh, I have to remove some rear downforce, make it turn them better, since I can't add front downforce. Oh, maybe this is an issue, spring rate. Slam the front, put the rear only slightly higher. I mean, it's almost slammed. We'll try that out. Yeah, thanks, I'm gonna need some luck. I hope I put enough power into it to where I can just overpower them on the straights and they'll just kind of beat me in the corners. Oh, now they're faster. Fun. Oh, wait, no, they're not. Oh, cold tires suck. And the brakes suck too. Wow. This thing is not fun. Yeah. It's doable. But with the cold tires right now, this thing is not fun to drive at all. Just doesn't corner. Oof. Okay, I'm restarting. Oh. Man, I don't know how to make this thing better. I might have to I don't know. I might have to get the race car. I don't know how to get it, though. I think because it's a prize car. See, I'm tuning this based on like a GT Sport tune, but like I don't even know if that's a good thing to do. Yeah, racing the really good race cars is not fun. Oh yeah, thanks, man. Just turn these up a little more so I don't have that stupid oversteer on exit. Take off the front camber? Like, lower? Like that? Will it make it better? I'll try it. Alright, more rear downforce. I mean, this is gonna make it feel like a dude tune, isn't it? Like, I wanna be able to drive it. Alright. We'll see how that feels. No, it understeers way more. Actually, eh. It's more drivable, but it's more understeery. AI just bullying me. Oh, come on. My hope is that they have to pit, so it'll open up the opportunity for me to pit. Because if they don't have to pit, then they'll just beat me. Oh, it's really bad through that corner. I mean, I can contend with them, but I mean, it's definitely not like an easy task, especially for like almost a 20 minute race, I think. 15 minute race. I just lose everything at the first like three corners of the track. Through here, it's alright, and then with this long straightaway, I catch them. now my tires are starting to heat up, so we'll see how it goes. No, I think I've got it pretty good now. I just have to hope that they pit so I can pit too. Or even if I don't have to pit, then I'll beat them. And they, if they pit at least. This first place is driving away. Man, this thing is really, like, tough to drive perfectly. Feels like driving a Bugatti, like in GT6. Okay, there's the pass for the lead. See, now that my tires have heated up a bit, it feels alright. Like I can throttle off confidently now. Oh, wow. Yeah, I think in order to get the race car, I think I have to beat this cup, huh? I mean, if this car could tune the front downforce, that would make it a lot better, but it can't. But I think I've got it driving pretty good now with the tires warmed up. The brakes just suck. The race car or the C12? Oh, he shoved me wide. Stay back. I might not need to pit, since I'm only on yellow tires on lap 5. But once they turn red, the tires just die, so I don't know. I should have gotten a little bit of a harder tire. Or a softer and just pit. Yeah, the prize car for this event's a race car, so they just expect you to beat it with this car. I mean, it's doable now that we've gotten a better tune for it, but I mean, it'd be much easier to do with the race car, you know? Especially since you face all race cars. Man, this thing just sucks at this corner. Off throttle time with this thing is just a boat. It feels like a Bugatti. brakes like a Bugatti too. Alright, I'm pulling a gap now. So my tires last. The Vertigo. I don't think I have that right now. I'm not really trying to buy many cars because most of the cups, as of right now, I can do with the cars I have. And plus, I think the Vertigo is like 2 million, isn't it? Isn't the Professional League Vitz Cup, isn't that like the one that everyone says is like impossible? I want to see if I can do that today too. Because like the Toyota Vitz is just a meme. I wish I still had the pink one. I think when I got the pink prize car, I think I sold it. Well, I'm going to have to wait till I'm on the long straightaway to read that, Freddy. Okay, I'm really pulling a gap here. I don't know if their tires are falling off or just mine are in a good, like, sweet spot right now. Looks like I can make it to the end on this set, though. I hope. Just once they start turning red, the tires just suck really bad. Like, they fall off a cliff. Alright, so Gillette dealership or passage to Colesso, okay. I think, oh yeah, that's the endurance event, that's the Rome endurance event. Yeah, see, I'd rather win the F1 car than the Vertigo from that. Or in the European Championship, Amateur League. Oh, then I must have it already. Road car better on tires than race car. Oh, okay. I'm like reading your chat and I like realize I'm in the wall. Yeah, so I might have the Vertigo then, because I've already completed all the Amateur League. But most of this save was done when I was like really young, so there's a chance I might have sold it for credits, because I didn't really realize once you get a prize car, you can't really get it back. So I might have it. I'll have to look. You like the way it handles in this game, or in like some of the other games? The Vertigo. Is it Vertigo or Vertigo? I don't really know. I think it's Vertigo because it's like Italian. I think it's Italian. So far, out of the cars I've driven, the one I love the most... this corner just doesn't work with this car. The one I love the most... Oh yeah, see, they're all pitting right here. Which is stupid, it's the last lap, but okay. is the Subaru Impreza touring car. It drives so good. It just shreds tires. Oh, it's Belgian. I didn't know Belgium made cars. Oh, I'm reading your guys' chats and just dying. Alright, well, we've got this wind locked up, so. Yeah, once my tires heated up, it actually wasn't too bad. It also kind of helps that they have to pit on the last lap, which is kind of dumb, but. There's a red Vertigo? Oh, yeah, the red one. Okay, I remember that. Yeah, I agree, the red one does look better than the yellow. I just forgot, like, the red one existed. Alright, let's see if I have it. No, I must have sold it. RIP. This car is amazing, though. Oh boy, it's what I'm gonna have to use in a few races. Yeah, so I don't have the Gillette, I guess. Yeah, on the Subaru 965, it's so fast. Like, it feels like I'd say it feels like a NASCAR in terms of speed, but, like, it's even faster, I think. But then it has, like, the downforce of, a Le Mans car, almost. It feels so nice. And then the four-wheel drive, you just power out of corners. It's insane. So this is the Vitz Cup. I don't know which one's faster. I'll have to figure out which one's faster and then just max it. And then try doing all these. Probably could. I beat like the wind with just I literally put rubber bands on my controller and just let the Escudo just drive itself around test course. Okay. So I already have, I think I have two of the 1.5s for some reason. I need to figure out a way to get the chat to pop up on the stream so people can, that like aren't looking at chat, understand what I'm talking about. I tried using Streamlabs, but it was just really laggy. So I'm using the Elgato capture. Man, these guys just bully me. Faster is a relative term. What does that mean? Also, have you ever noticed that this is turn 1 and 2 of G GT 5 and 6's roam when you do this trek in reverse through there. This whole section is the same. But instead of turning left up here, you would turn right. Yeah, but I mean, what does that mean? Like, is the other one better at cornering or something? I mean, they're both pretty bad cars, so I mean, one should be better than the other. I mean, it's not like they're supercars and it's like, oh, one's better at cornering, one's faster on the straight. I don't really know. God, these guys are just bully. And then I miss the Apex. Awesome. Oh, they're both so slow. Yeah. But I mean, one should be faster than the other, right? That little crest all over that corner just throws you off guard. It looks like you're gonna be able to make the corner and then you hit the crest and then you just hit the wall. I know, I need to stop hitting on the walls and I need to stop reading chat while I'm driving too. And like, this car is really bad. Like, you guys don't understand how bad this car is until you actually drive it. But hey, I'm beating the race cars. That's all that matters. Yeah, they're all going to pit on the last lap, I know. Lamborghini? What? It's a Pagani, it's not a Lamborghini. Hold on,
What's the difference between my girlfriend and a Lamborghini? I didn't cry last night about losing my Lamborghini. Huh. So you just missed. I beat the first race, and now I'm on the second race. It's just the same track, but in reverse. And then I'll get the race car for beating them. They're still probably going to pit on the last lap, but I'm pulling away from them anyway. That's pretty much all you missed. Next up, I'm probably going to do the Vitz Cup, just for the memes. Also, Michael, I don't know if you realize, but yesterday I did the 2-hour endurance event of Trial Mountain. And then you have a 1 in 4 chance of getting a Formula Gran Turismo. Yeah, I didn't get it. I got an S2000 instead. So, yeah. Just, you know, red line luck. Stop chatting so much, I can't read it. This track doesn't have long enough straights. Alright, so, oh yeah, I'm beating the race cars. Never made a banger one-liner streamer has to stop what he's doing. Yeah, that's true. Oh yeah, they coming out, director. Yeah, Trial Mountain. Yeah. It's such a meme. It went one spot past the Formula One car and gave me an S2000, which was probably the worst out of the four. Because the other ones look like, one looked like a Le Mans car, probably a Toyota, the Toyota GT1. And then the other one, couldn't really tell what it was, but it looked faster than an S2000. Probably was a JGTC car, the fourth car. These laps are going by pretty quick. I like this corner how it's downhill. I don't know, it just feels cool. I don't know why, this car just doesn't like these, like, few corners. Those two, and then the one coming up here. Oh yeah, the GT40 on the daily wheel. What? Why would I break so late there? I mean, to be honest, even if I won the GT40 and GT4, I probably wouldn't. I mean, I probably would have driven it once and never again. Like most of the cars they've added to GT4, but you know. You know, one thing I never realized is that the Golf livery GT40 is in this car, or in this game. I didn't know that. So I was like looking through some of the dealerships and stuff. The Clio? What about the Clio? Alright, I need to stop reading chat. I was facing few days ago on stream, I was facing the Clio, but like, he was like way slower than all the other cars in the race. It was just kind of funny. Oh, the GT40 is really good in this game? Yeah, I didn't even know it was in this game. I thought that was like a GT4 thing. What do you think is like the best overall car in this game? Because everyone says the Escudo, but like that thing can't corner. What do you think it is, dude? Because in my opinion, that the Subaru car I just showed you guys, that's an insane car. Well, okay, yeah, the F1 car, obviously, but, like, obviously, the Le Mans cars, like, the GT1 and the 787B are gonna be good, but, like, I don't know, in terms of, like, I don't know, I that's just a relative question, to be honest, maybe, I don't know, because I feel like that Subaru is just a really good car for, like, its quote-unquote class. Especially if you just put like a $20,000 upgrade on it, it gains like 300 horsepower, which I think is hilarious. The R390 and the GT1. I mean, yeah, I mean, they're LMPs, or just Le Mans cars, I guess. Is the GT1 road car better than the GT1? Because I have the road car, but I don't have like the actual like GT1 with like the ketchup packet livery. God damn, the tire's gone. Alright, race over. Yeah, it's a good road car. I was kind of hoping that it would count as a quote-unquote normal car for this game, but I guess it doesn't. Or maybe that's because I have upgrades on it. Okay. Oh yeah, I get the race car. The car I needed entering the thing, I get for beating it. Alright, so should we do the Vitz Cup or the four-wheel drive and MR Cup? So these two. For the Vitz. I already know you guys are gonna say Vitz. Yep. Alright. We'll do the Vitz Cup. Alright. You can't put wings in this game. Why did I only put a sports suspension on this thing before? What the heck? What was like 12-year-old me doing? Yeah, you can't put the wings. But you can get a rim job. Medium slick or medium? Oh yeah, it has been almost 365 days. Which one, medium slick or medium? I want to be able to do a whole race without... I thought I got the stage 2 turbo. Medium, okay. They better last the whole race. It's already purchased. And these two, you can't. Yeah. Alright, let's get it over with. Should I do a test race first? Or should I just go straight into it? Yeah, it's a golden vids. I wish I saw the pink one, but I think the pink one was the other type. And I remember, because like that's like one of the first prize cars you get. And it's just pink. I think I got really mad and just sold it when I was like 12. Let's just go straight into it. Because I can change the setup between races. Dang. Oh wait, no, that's spring rate. That's not right, right? I don't really know how to tune front wheel drive, but I really hope this doesn't just suck. I feel like I need to whiten this out. I hope that's enough gear. Oh, it's this track again. Nose to cheek. Oh, dang. Wow, that black one had a power move on the outside. Holy crap. Okay. Stiffening the springs really helped this thing, but it makes it understeer a bit. So I might need to add a little bit more gear next track. Good thing this thing has short straightaways. Wow. It's so weird going from that fast car that couldn't brake to this thing that is too slow to where you almost don't need the brake. Wow. Okay, so it turns on a dime, but then once you start turning, it just doesn't want to turn anymore. Wow, it breaks really good. Doesn't turn though. How do I get it to turn better at high speed? Dude. The brakes are too good. I need to lower the brake strength. I'm like barely tapping the brakes and I'm like slowing down like 10 miles an hour at a time. Alright, well now that I have clear track, it should be okay. I might need to lower the front brake strength. And just like a lot, and maybe just the rear a little bit, just so it breaks a little bit less, and then also like just pivots more once I tap the brake. Slam the front ride height, max the rear roll bar. I mean, I've pretty much already done that. Better than hitting the wall. What's better than hitting the wall? Braking, I guess. But like the braking is kind of making me like hit inside walls almost. It's like too good. Because the initial turn-in for this car is really good because it's really stiff. But then it just doesn't turn after that. And then once you gas it, it just doesn't turn anymore. I mean, GT3, GT5, GT6, and GT4, I've played by far the most. And I've played a little bit of GT1, but I was really too young to even have, like, like, enjoy, like, not really, I can't say enjoy, because I loved it. I was, like, maybe, like, four. I loved it, but, I mean, I couldn't have, like, enjoyed it to its fullest, because, I mean, I didn't, I just played arcade mode. GT2 and GT4, I've only played maybe, like, 10 hours each. I want to play through GT4 at some point. See what everyone says. Everyone says it's the best, but, I mean, I haven't really played it that much. But from what I have played, I just feel like GT3 is better. I don't know. I mean, obviously GT4 has more content than GT3, but in my opinion, just GT3 just is perfection. Just wish it had the content GT4 had. Yeah, I do have multiple copies of every game, for sure. I have 8 copies of GT Sport, and they're all different, like, versions. The rarest GT... See, the thing is, I have a bunch of rare GTs, but I haven't been able to play them because they're all, like, PAL or Japan, and I don't have a PAL or Japan console, and I don't really do emulation, so, I mean, I can, but, I've emulated GT2, or GT2002 concept, but just the controls just feel weird because it's not actual hardware. Like, I'm using a PS3 controller with DS4 Windows, and just it doesn't match. Like, it just feels off. GT4 is the best. I think GT3 is the best, but I need to play through GT4. GT5 is really close to GT3, but that's mainly because GT5 was, like, my early teen years, and that's just, like, the time of your life you, like, kind of relish the most, I guess, in terms of nostalgia. So, but I still think GT5 is a really close second behind GT3. Yeah, GT5 and GT6 are definitely underrated. I don't understand why everyone... I mean, I kind of understand GT6. Because, I mean, it's just GT5 with less content. But then again, online for GT6 was really fun. Even though it was really broken. But it's definitely more fun than the online for GT Sport. I like GT Sport's FIA, but it's kind of lost its magic. Alright, if you have to go, Freddy, go ahead. Thanks for stopping by, for sure. I plan to be streaming this a lot more now that we're all in quarantine and stuff, so. Now, and actually, I've gotten all this stuff to work. So. Yeah, I really like GT5. I just can't say anything's better than GT3. It's just, I don't know. Seems like half of them pitted. I'm gonna have to pit because I won't be able to last to the end. Because I should have gotten the harder tires, but you told me to get the medium tires. Yeah, I know the Gran Turismo Wiki has them, but I just like playing through the game and just getting surprised. But thanks for letting me know all that, Freddy, and thanks for stopping by. Yeah, GT6 was lacking in single player. Yeah, for sure, GT6 was better online, but GT5 was far superior in single player. I don't see why people say this cup is so hard. I mean, it's only the first race, but I'm blowing them out the water once my tires heat it up.
GT5 had a better profile and menu interface as well. GT5, I mean, the aesthetic of the menu was great, but the navigation was awful.
And I really liked the trading in GT5, even though towards the end of the life cycle, everyone just started trading hacked cars and stuff, but I kind of wish the trading was in more Gran Turismo games.
And I kind of wish, like, the newer GT games had soundtracks like this game, GT3, because this soundtrack is just perfect. I mean, granted, they have some really good songs, but a majority of the songs just kind of suck, in my opinion. Like, it's nothing like this game. Like, this game, 90% of the songs are just perfect.
Yeah, music today sucks. It does. Yeah, you weren't here yesterday, dude, but yesterday we were talking about how sometime in the future, I believe we'll be able to crack the, like, source code of, like, the PS2 and PS1 Gran Turismo's and be able to, like, add in our own assets. Because I'm in some, like, Discord servers where they're doing sort of some similar things to that, but nothing to, like, that extent yet. But I really believe that, like, maybe in, like, 10 years or so, we'll be able to put, like, other tracks, like say, like, Spa-Francorchamps Champs and, like, Dragon Trail and, like, kind of any track we want, as long as we, like, create it, we can put it in, like, GT3, and I think that would be awesome. Yeah, the NTSC is way different than PAL for music. It's really... they really changed it up in the regions. Why is this, like, a notoriously hard cup? It's really easy. Once my tires heated up and I got past them, it's been really easy.
Yeah, that would be so fun. Like, I was thinking, like, imagine, like, a downscaled Dragon Trail on GT3. Like, that would be amazing.
Because we kind of came on the topic because everyone was like, oh, why isn't... we were talking how yesterday, how why isn't Trial Mountain in GT Sport? And I was like, well, I think that would be cool, but, like, why isn't, like, why... like, it would be cool to have tracks that aren't in GT3 to be able to be put in GT3. Like, I think that would be even cooler.
Because, like, games like Mario Kart Wii, they're able to do that. They're able to make their own tracks and even put it in the game. Because they have, like, access to, like, the source codes and stuff. Somehow, but I don't know. They have, like, a whole community that just makes, like, Mario Kart tracks, like, custom tracks for Mario Kart Wii. I think it would be cool if, like, GT3, GT4 had that capability at some point in the future.
Or even, like, upscaling, because, like, in GT4 you can have 1080i. What if someone figured out a way to get 1080i on GT3? I don't know. That'd be really cool, too. wonder if there's a way to transfer like cars from GT4 and like put them into GT3. That might be a possibility too, if they run on like the same engine. Yeah, dude, that would be awesome. Like the ultimate Gran Turismo game. And like every track that's ever been in GT in it as well, or something like that. I don't know. That would be really cool. Yeah, we were also talking about, like, Gran Turismo PSP was a game, but, like, what if that was, like, what if they made, like, a Gran Turismo PSP type of game, but for your phone? That'd be pretty cool, too. Yeah, the sausage curbs. Oh, they're so bad in GT Sport. Whoa! Well, there was a sausage curb there. I've got this car feeling a lot better than it did last race. I don't know if it's just because it's a better track, but I don't know. Yo, dude, tomorrow I'm gonna run a GT Sport lobby for my birthday. Probably like around 3 Eastern. I don't know. I might. Yeah. I mean, yeah, I really wish this could be like upscaled to 1080 or something, but it looks better on stream than it does on my TV. Interesting how this corner's so flat. I wonder if that's how it used to be, because like in more modern Laguna Secas and GT, it's like a banked corner through there. I wonder if they reprofiled it at some point. I don't really know. Oh, you'll be working the 4:30 tomorrow. It might still be open around that time. I don't know. I might start it at 4 your time then, and hopefully you can get home for like the tail end of it. Because I wanted to do it like later, but everyone that would come is going to be in doing FIA races, so invited. Oh yeah, I might get you your liveries done tonight or something. Yeah, it would be, yeah, I live in the Pacific Ocean. let's see, so that would be 1 your time, so it'd be like 9 p.m. your time if you're in the UK, right? Yeah, UK. So it'd be like 9 p.m. your time. Let's just say it would be an hour and 20 minutes ago is probably when I would open the room. I don't know. Whatever time an hour and 20 minutes ago would be. What's your ratings, like your driver rating, sportsmanship rating on GT Sport? Because I might set the room based on that, because I don't want like noobs to join. But I want to keep it open for everyone. Actually, dude, what's yours? Are you still an EB or something? Oh, no, you have an AS account, right, dude? Yeah, I really like this track in GT3. It seems pretty realistic. I mean, compared to how it is in other games, except for that one, the second to last corner, it's really flat compared to how it is in the later games. And it seems, the track seems a little bit wider than it is in later games, but, and less runoff. But then again, I don't know how Laguna looked in 2001. Okay, so if I set it, you'll be able to join on your A-plus account. Oh, I forget how long. Oh, the pit lane doesn't go all the way through turn one on this game. Are they not pitting? Uh-oh. Yeah, I guess that's true. I'll just set the sportsmanship to, like, B or something. No, I'll set the sportsmanship to S. I'll make it, like, CS or something, I don't know. Crossed him over there. Hey, dude, what the heck, jerk? There, you couldn't pit, idiot. Allen Iverson. Yeah, I kind of just screwed over the blue car because he was a jerk and he couldn't pit that lap, so that's what he gets. When you tap the gas, you just go straight. I mean, obviously it's a front-wheel drive car, but... I don't know what happened there. Oh, hi, Charlotte. Okay. Oh. Tell her I said hi, too. I don't know how I used to drive in this view. Can't see the road. Or like, see the car kind of, I mean, you can see the car screwing up, but it just doesn't feel as quick as the other view. Like here, you can see every movement left to right. Two down, three more to go. Yeah, the blue car finished last where it belongs.
Hello? Oh, okay, there we go. My sound started messing up, so I had to fix it, and I thought I lost the commentary there. But it's working. Oh, now we've got this track. 10 laps? No, I'm not doing this race. I'm gonna exit, take the 0 points, and then just get gold on it later. Not on stream. And I hate this track. Oh, it's reverse. Wow, I don't think I've ever driven this track in reverse. Yeah, Route 11. Yeah, I don't really like Route 11. Man, I don't ever recall doing this race in reverse. Man. That's way easier than the forward version. That corner. Oh, my front tire is almost yellow, but my rears are blue. Dang. I need to keep constantly looking up at the map to see what corner comes next, because I don't know it.
That's a flat out corner. I need to remember that. This one's a really easy one too. Oh, never mind. It's not that easy. Yeah, he messed up the exit there. Flat out. Cool. Gotta remember, it's flat out there and a little braking here. I just found it interesting that there's like a catch fence on that corner there. Like a NASCAR catch fence. Oh. Oh, so the blue car is going to be a jerk. I see. Man, I don't know. I really don't like this track. It'd be embarrassing if I lose. Oh, dang, I just lost all the ground. And he's gonna bully me? Awesome. Making it tough on me here.
Ah, the red tire.
Yeah, that's it. My tires are gone.
Gained a lot right there. I don't really know what happened. Oh, this corner's gonna suck. Red tire. Actually, not too bad.
Wow, he slowed down a lot. I think his tires are worse than mine. I might go one more lap. Ooh, because I want to finish on good tires. I don't want to finish on red. Okay, maybe not. It's not really working out. No, I'm going to go one more. Hope I can come out close to them. Have fresher tires for the end.
Gonna make sure it rotates before I gas up now.
Hope it wasn't a mistake staying on an extra lap.
Man, that leading car is just way ahead.
Of their pack.
Silver car.
Alright, pit here. Alright, let's hope I stay out or I get out really close to them. Oh, they're passing me already. Oh no, I might have made a mistake. Alright, well, I'm gonna have fresher tires to the end, so. Gotta drive hard.
Rotate.
Might be in trouble. Whoa, it hooked on that curb. All right, 6 seconds. Ooh, that's going to be real tough. I really got to get through these three cars really quickly. Chase down the silver one. I'm not even gaining ground. My tires are still cold. And I get bullied. That might have been it right there. Man, I lost more than half a second from that. Alright, I think I have to get the draft and pass this red car on the straight here. Oh, okay, I've gained a second. Maybe the silver car is kind of falling off. I think he's the one who pit on lap 4 instead of the rest on lap 5. So his tires might be going off soon. Oh, come on. Okay, I can see the silver car up there. Hoping I would hit his door. Okay, it seems like we're all catching a silver car. So I might have to beat the blue car if the silver car falls off and loses the lead. No, I couldn't see. Man. I was trying to cut cross over and like couldn't see and hit the wall. Okay, well, remember the blue car's tires fell off on the end of his fifth lap, and he has to do 5 more, so maybe it'll happen again. Because I only have to go 4, he has to go 5. Okay, that's good that we got by him. Probably get up close to the blue car here. Ooh, 2.7, I think it's doable. Alright, silver car is falling off. I think we're racing the blue car for the win here. Yeah, I think their tires are gone. I think staying out the extra lap, I thought it hurt me, but they're really losing time now. Especially that silver car. He pit on lap 4, so he's already on his 5th lap of tires. Alright, there we go. Alright, I think we got it. Whew, man, I was 6 seconds back and I thought I was going to get not first. There we go. Yeah, you guys fight each other. I'm gone.
All right, yeah, see you. Thanks for coming by. Yeah, I think I've got it now. I was scared about this race, but staying out that extra lap helped me with the tires at the end of the race here. Thank you. Someone's, yeah, the silver car is pitting again. Yeah, their tires are really gone, so. Because I definitely wasn't this quick throughout the entire race. It's just the tire difference. Hey, dude. You missed probably the most intense race with this one. Because I suck at this track, and the AI are actually pretty decent. We were mid-pack almost the whole race. And then I stayed out an extra lap, and my tires were, like, all red. But I was like, I can sacrifice a slow lap here and then have better tires than them at the end. But I came out of the pits, like, 7 seconds behind. And I was like, oh, that's not good. But the tire advantage really helped out. As you can see, I'm about to win by, like, 10 seconds. I hate this track so much. And the red car finished in the back. I think he was up front in the championship. Yeah, there we go. Yeah, I skipped the third race because it was test course, and I wasn't about to do 10 laps of test course on stream. So. Yeah, I mean, I hate the track to begin with, and then just on this track, the AI are just really good. Like, I thought I was going to lose at one point. I mean, I was like 7 seconds behind. This is gonna be my last race before I head off. Probably head on to Sport. Probably gonna party chat if you want. You want to do a share play while I make your liveries. Just chill out for like an hour or two while I do them. Yeah, okay. This will be my last race. It'll be like another 20 minutes or so. And then I'm going to take like a short break, maybe like 10 minutes, and then hop on sports. Like probably like 30 to 40 minutes I'll be on sport. I think they made the AI really good on this track too. I don't really know. On the reverse version specifically. Come on. Stop understeering. Yeah. I mean, most of the time at the end game, you have like a way overpowered car, but a lot of the time in this game, they actually like challenge you if you don't have an overpowered car. Like yesterday in my endurance race, for a good portion of it, I was really battling with an NSX because he was like just really quick. And I was like, dang, he's going to make this like whole 2 hours just be really hard. But then after the first pit stop, he kind of just was slow. It was interesting. Yeah, Grand Valley East Reverse. Every time I go through this corner here in reverse, I get like PTSD over that. There.
The Loctite. Yeah. I've got that car in this game, the Loctite. Car feels weird. I don't know. I think. I'll have to look. I think they're pretty much stock. You might be able to do like a turbo or something. That's about it. Because most of the race cars, you can only do like a turbo, and that's it. I always liked how in like GT6 and GT5, like these S's right here were squared instead of rounded. It just felt more flowy. Look, it's Redline. Redline billboards. And Pfister billboards. Back there, Pfister. Dead. They're all pitting. Yeah, red right front for sure. It's so dead. It's weird, once they hit red in this game, they just absolutely die. Because like in this game, for some reason, yellow is like peak optimum wear, which is weird. Like, you would think green would be better, but yellow's better. And then once they hit like orange-ish red, like they just die. Like your lap times will just fall off a cliff. I'm about to do an extra lap. I'm gonna do what I did last race, but I had a gap. I have a gap this time, so I just want to see what kind of lap I can do with these tires.
I'm doing this lap a lot better than I did last lap. Stream lagging? Or is it just my phone? Plenty of gap. I'm like turning too good now. I'm like sleeping, falling asleep. Man, the pack of AI are really close. They're just a caterpillar down there. Yeah. Cure Insomnia, drive the Vitz, the golden Vitz. With Supernova goes pop in your ears, blasting. Oof. That hurt. One more lap. Ooh. What price car will I get? A Vitz? Let's take guesses on what I will get. I think a Vitz. My third one. Probably will, because they usually theme it based off the cup you race, and it's a Vitz cup, so they'll give me a Vitz probably. NSX? That'd be dope. The Castrol NSX, I hope. That'd be dope. But I doubt it. It'll be a Vitz. They always like to screw me over with the prize cards. Got a minute gap on the AI, what the heck? Alright. $7,000, that's it. Yikes, man. Trophy, cool.
He got cake.
It's gonna be a Vitz. Oh no, it's a prize wheel. Oh no, look, there's a Vitz. It's gonna be the Vitz. Oh no, I think it's the Civic actually. Ha! I told you, dude! I told you! Oh my god, I always. They always screw me over. Oh. What were the other cards? Let me go back. What the heck was that, man? I thought it was going to be like the Spoon Civic. It kind of looked like a Civic, but it wasn't even that. Yeah, let's see. So, that looks like an Opel Astra, one of them. The Vitz. Looks like a Supra, but like the road car. I couldn't even tell what the fourth car was. It looked like it was a race car, though. So it looked like the Skyline, Super GT Skyline, an Opel Astra, or like a Supra, and it gave me a Vitz. Light blue. Unbelievable. Oh. And then I have to go back and like do this race again with like rubber bands and stuff on my controller, because I'm not doing 10 laps of just holding X. Yeah, I know, I always get the worst possible one. Yesterday I got an S2000 instead of a Formula One car. Or like, two other good cars. Freaking stupid, man. Because in order to beat the career mode, I have to do this cup. To get 100%, I have to do the Formula One Cup. In order to do the Formula One Cup, except for Super Speedway and probably Test Course, for these other actual, you know, tracks, I need an F1 car. I can't beat it with anything else. And I'm just never going to get one. Because in order to get them, you have to beat these. I've already beaten two and didn't get one. So I have no luck. Let's see, where's the one I got yesterday? I got this one yesterday. It's not a bad car, but like, it's not an F1 car, you know? To beat F1 cars? I don't know, man. I have a 787B. Let me test it out real quick. Where's my... I'm just going to go into a race because I have a tune on it, I think. I'm not going to do the race. I'm just going to like see if I can even like keep up. I'm pretty sure I can't beat the Formula One cars, even with the 787. Yeah, I've already, like, pretty much tuned this thing. No, I have to get an F1 car, pretty much. That's the only way.
Because I've... The only way I beat them before on Super Speedway, which is an oval, was because I was able to pit less than them. I just want to see if I can even, like, get close to them. Do you think? They're really good. Look, even just off the line. Oh, they took each other out. Oh, I might be able to. Especially once my tires heat up. Oh, it's 27 laps, though. And it's a 10-race event. Oh. This is going to be a long cup once I get to it. No, I don't think it... Yeah, it's fully upgraded. No, I can't keep up with them with this. My only chance is if they pit before me. If I can do one less pit stop, it might be possible, but besides that, it's not. Make sure it's fully upgraded. I'm like 95% sure it is. Yeah, it's fully upgraded, so. Yeah, I mean, I have an alright setup on it already. I mean, I would have to drive all 27 laps perfectly or hope that they have to do, like, one more pit stop than me. But, again, that's like, endgame. And I'm going to do all the endurance races first, just in case I actually do get an F1 car. Because I really want one. Next one I'm going to do is probably the Seattle 100. No limitations, so I can, like, take my Subaru into there and just shred. Or even the 77, take that in there. Yeah, because, see, this thing has almost the same amount of power as the 787, but it's four-wheel drive, and it just feels amazing. So, yeah. Probably the next time I stream, I'm gonna do these two cups, the MR and F, or four-wheel drive. And maybe Spider Roadster. I got some short cups that I need to complete still. Like this. Can I take race cars in here? Yeah, okay. So I would use my Loctite here. Beat that. Beat Turbo. And then these three. So... And then I'll do all the endurance events. Alright, I'm gonna end the stream here. Thanks for watching.